black album. I mean, it was, I guess it was called Metallica, but I always call it the black album. There was no real theme to this one. It was simple black cover, and you had to listen to the music. You wouldn't be distracted by a drawing on the front.
It just came from a place that was obviously very magical. And you just can't argue with the songs.
And you know what's amazing is that it keeps on going. To this day, the Black Album sells, you know, right around 1 million copies a year. It's our dark side of the moon.
We had built it up, and it felt good to get the recognition with the Black Album.
There were a lot of planets aligning. It was the right songs with the right new producer, with the right new attitude, with the right new recording approach, with the right timing.
For us, it was a long, slow build, and we built up a family that cared about us and weren't there just for the trend or fad, you know? So we had built it up, and it felt good to get the recognition.
It was great classic rock, but it was smart. It had like a futurist quality to it. It wasn't like anything that you heard on old heavy metal records. It wasn't like anything on the radio.
These are the outsiders. These are the guys, for four albums, only 10 stations ever played their music in America. They didn't make a video until almost the end of their fourth album's run.
They're a garage band who was supposed to tour for the rest of their life, and that was it. They were a band that was developing, irregardless of their arena status, very organically on press and metal radio. Nobody else gave a rat's ass about Metallica. They were not planned to be the biggest rock band in the world.
But that's Metallica. They're unique in the world of not making things normal and not making things safe and not making things easily digestible.
To have one record like that in your career is amazing. It's really amazing.